Here we want to calculate the volume of water vapor using the ideal gas law, and then we want to compare it to values from the steam tables at 500 degrees C and 2 pressures. So looked up the values from the steam table. Those are the values here. And let's use part A. Let's apply the ideal gas law. We're going to calculate volume per mole first, so RT over P, ideal gas constant, 8.314 times 10 to the minus 6 for the units of cubic meters, megapascals per mole and Kelvin. The temperature, 500 plus 273 to make temperature in Kelvin. And the pressure, 0.5 megapascals. If I do this calculation, I get 0.0129 cubic meters per mole. Now I want to compare the steam table, so I'm going to convert this to cubic meters per kilogram. So I converted 18 grams per mole for water and then from grams to kilograms. So here's the ideal gas value. You can see it's quite close. So percent error, take the difference, 0.714 minus 0.7109. Divide that by the steam table value, the correct value. Multiply by 10 squared to make the percent. I get 0.44%. So steam tables, ideal gas law, not that different at this pressure. Let's make the comparison at the higher pressure now. Well, I don't have to repeat all the calculations. Let's just call volume 2, the volume we just calculated, and then correct for the pressure. So 0.714 cubic meters per kilogram, 0.5 megapascals is the calculation we just did. We're now interested in volume at 30 megapascals, and that number is 0.0119 cubic meters per kilogram. Well, we can see the value from the steam tables is smaller, so 0.0119 minus 0.0087 over 0.0087 times 10 squared, that'll be the percent error, and I get 37% error. And of course, this is not even a vapor, these conditions. We're above the critical temperature, we're above the critical pressure, and so we wouldn't expect the ideal gas law to be very close to the actual value.